AMC's position on wind power is very similar to all other renewable energy sources, and that is that there's no energy source out there that's entirely environmentally benign. And consequently, when AMC takes a look at wind power, we're asking ourselves not only the benefits but also the challenges that come from it, and then how we can appropriately site wind power in the locations where its impact is least, and at the same time mitigate for those impacts when it's sited in those locations. One of the unfortunate situations here in the Northeast is that the best wind, if we're really considering trying to get a lot of energy from wind, is located either along the coast or offshore and on the mountain peaks because of the way that winds get accelerated when they bump into obstacles like ridgelines and mountaintops. And our mountaintops are actually some of the least developed with some of the highest ecological values. So the challenge comes with wind power in the Northeast is trying to find those locations where the impacts from wind power are not going to degrade the ecological and recreational resources. AMC has developed a set of wind power siting criteria, which is available on our website. And those criteria take a look at ecological, recreational, visual, and other resources. And we ask ourselves whether the particular project that we're looking at is going to impact resources that are of national, regional, or state significance. The important thing is to first get your facts correct before you as an individual or we as an organization decide whether we're going to support an individual wind project or oppose it. And I think one of the most important things that AMC members can do is to encourage their states to develop strong wind power siting policies so that we're not reactively responding to proposals that come up, but rather we're proactively proposing projects in the locations where the impacts are the least.